This here is the culmination of his work. We saw him in the morning speaking with the fish brokers. We saw his staff working together in the back. We saw him prepping his fish for the service beforehand. We watched him put it all together in front of us. And now we are going to taste the combined efforts and passions of everyone involved. And it's magic.
斉藤隆です。店の名前は寿司斉藤です。独立してからは、12年です。
A lot of sushi. We love it. We pretty much have sushi every single week. And though we've had a large range of sushi from cheap to Michelin star, we've always wanted to know what makes good sushi good.
Recently, we had the very rare opportunity to shoot with who many people believe is the best sushi chef in all of Tokyo. He's had 3 Michelin stars for many years now, and his restaurant is pretty much booked for the rest of his life. And not only did he make sushi for us, but he also brought us along for the entire ride, right from the first thing in the morning in Tsukiji Fish Market.
Tsukiji Fish Market is the biggest wholesale fish and seafood market in the entire world, and also one of the largest wholesale food markets of any kind. Now, we've heard a lot about Tsukiji before and about how people go to bidding wars for fish and tuna, and we prepared to like fight this crowd to get our shots and to deal with a lot of tours and tourists, but we didn't realize we were going to a special part of the market where tours and cameras are forbidden.
なんだろう、まあ、昔から僕らの目利きっていうのもすごく大事なんですけど、やっぱり最初に魚買ってくるのは仲買さんじゃないですか。仲買の目利きがいい、だから人を僕らは見てるわけですよね。っていうのは そこも、まあ、ある意味信頼関係ですね、やっぱりね。例えばじゃあ値段聞いて最高の魚、あ、いいなと思った魚が値段聞いて高いからやめるっていうわけに、そこではもうある意味変なし、自分にもちょっと嘘ついちゃってるし、さっき言った妥協もしてるわけだから、まあ、とにかくその扱う素材、それこそお客さんに対しても、まあ、妥協とか、まあ、嘘はつかないということですね、まあ、妥協とか嘘をついた瞬間にまあ、そのまま僕にやっぱり返ってくるので。
We saw a very good example of this trusting relationship with the wholesalers in which Saito asked one of them for a specific fish, and though they had it, they didn't have what they felt was up to Saito's quality, and they could very easily have sold it to Saito and made a quick buck, but because they have that trust with each other, they knew not to sell Saito something that wasn't good enough for his restaurant.
まあ、今日一緒に市場行って魚を選ぶ時の自分の好みと仲買が持ってきた魚のその好みがあった時、まず1個目はその嬉しさとかがあって、お店にこうお魚持って帰ってきて、まあ仕込みした時に予想通りのその質だったり油だったりっていうのを見た時に、およかったと。うん、
はい、橋場俊二です。
はい、遠藤典久です。
小林と申します。
あ、いい存在みたい。
まず一日の方だと裏との連携がうまくいって、若い子たちも、まあ、楽しくというかね、お客さん一人を満足させるためにみんなで動いてるっていう、そのなんだろう、組み立てができた時はやっぱり嬉しい。
Okay, so let's actually talk about his sushi.
まあ寿司というのはなんだろう、こう単純なものなんでね、まあオーソドックスな、お寿司ですね。ザお寿司という変わったこともやってないですし、イカはイカ、トロはトロと、そのものの味をもうダイレクトに味わっていただきたいですね。
One example of this is an aging sushi. And when people describe good sushi restaurants, they often call it the freshest sushi. And you get this visual of a big tuna flopping around on the table while the sushi master skillfully slices out a piece and gives it to you. Voila, it's fresh. But freshness like this doesn't necessarily mean greatness. In Saito's case,When he buys a tuna, it actually ages in the broker's refrigerator for up to 5 days.、Mm-hmm. Then Saito takes it back to his fridge and he ages it for another 3 to 5 days. But if the tuna is tough, he could age it for up to 2 weeks. Aging a tuna is actually really important to make it taste great. This is not a chef. This is a magician.The toughest part of the service is the very beginning when you're watching him cut all the fish and you're like, I want it now. But you're not going to have this until later on in the meal. He's cutting it now to get it to room temperature, to the right temperature for when you finally do eat it. Later on.
It's torture.
But you're just watching him.
First piece of the day. I'm so excited. I'm so excited to continue the rest of this meal.
Now is the perfect season for yellowtail.
Yeah.
This isn't something you could really put words to yet. Hold on. I'm sweating in the hands. I'm actually too afraid to use chopsticks because I think it's gonna show how my hands are shaking. Using my hands is the safer way to do this right now. Oh, here we've just begun.I think what's impressing me the most right now is watching how he prepares it. There's a fluidity. This is a choreography. He's not just slapping things together. He's dancing in front of us right now. These are flavors that are very difficult for me to explain right now. Like, you taste some of the vinegar of the fish, but you also taste the rice. Really, when it comes to great sushi, the flavor is in the rice.
うん、8割9割はシャリのその味、温度、硬さっていうのが寿司の中ではもう一番重要だと思います。はい。いやもう例えばじゃあ10としたら、まあ8、9ですね。
I'm about to try the marinated red tuna, which we saw him cutting at the beginning and then putting inside of a container to soak for a bit. I'm pretty excited. I'm just gonna go ahead and say that. I'm pretty excited. It's so soft.
Whoa.
But it's so soft. Mm-hmm. It just beautifully falls apart in your mouth.
でお客さんにお寿司を出した時に、まあ、美味しいっていうのは、まあ、飲食店やる上ではもう底辺というかじゃないと飲食店にはならないんだよね。でそれプラスアルファとして例えば今日嫌なことあったんだけど、まあ、斉藤君のお寿司食べたら元気が出たとか、まあ、次の予約までまた、これを糧に頑張れる元気が出るとかっていうこと言われるともう美味しいプラスもさらに嬉しいです。
This is so difficult because every piece I have I'm like that's my favorite piece.And the next piece is like, no, that's my favorite piece. And they're like, no, that's my favorite piece. Is this my favorite piece? Everything is my favorite piece. I love everybody in this room right now. I love everybody here.
それも舌だけじゃなくて、その心とか、あの脳にも訴えかけてるっていう。さっき言うとつながりで僕のパッションが伝わったっていうことなんでね。それはもうめちゃめちゃ嬉しいですね。
Not a chef. This is a magician. Whenever David Blaine performs a trick and everyone like jumps around and screams, I feel like that after every bite of this. I feel like looking around like, did you just see this? Did you just see what happened? What is the meaning of this?
I don't understand.
This kind of feels like if you're in a boxing match. Like I walked into this video with a set idea of things I wanted to say, but everything you eat is just so disorientingly good that I'm just mumbling and I'm not making... I had everything written out, like I need cue cards or something. I need help here. I feel like I've been punched in the face and I have no idea where I'm pointing anymore. And I just keep on getting these delicious pieces in the mouth. That didn't sound right, but whoa, I'm so confused in a really good way. What this is, it's not just about taste. It's about feeling.Every piece you taste, you forget about everything that happened for the rest of the day. You forget about the shit you had at your job. You forget about how crowded the subway was. You forget about the traffic jam. You eat this, and the only thing you can think is, holy shit, this is amazing. And you all of your worries melt away. Wow, I like you.You're a good guy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We're actually filming this part a couple weeks after eating at Sushi Saito because I think one of the things that makes it such a great experience is when you remember it. When you're there, you're overwhelmed by it all. But then a day later, you think to yourself, holy shit, that was a great meal. And then a month later, you're like, damn, that was some really, really good sushi. And I think...The magic of Sushi Saito is the way that it sticks with you in your memory afterward. dance.
There's something magical about watching this man move. He really does move like a dancer. Mm-hmm. And the concentration and the passion that he puts into every piece, it's just unbelievable. When he lays it down in front of you, he stares it down as he slowly backs away from the piece while he's making the next person's piece. And that's something that I've just never seen before in another chef.
その、まあ、僕が、なんだ、もう生きている瞬間からも、まあ、いろんな人が関わってくれてるということで、で最後のお寿司にするとこが僕ら の, その表現というか、だからみんなの思いを背負って一個の寿司にしてるので、総合的に見ていただいて一個のものを食べた時に、まあ、感動なり、その僕の情熱、僕のだけじゃなくて僕に関わってくれてる一個の寿司に関わってくれる人たちの、まあ、情熱を感じ取ってくれれば嬉しいし、
Thank you.